Hello students, welcome to our online study YouTube channel. Now in this video, you will learn about Langmuir adsorption isotherm. In the previous video, we discussed about different adsorption isotherm. First watch that video, then continue here. Because Friendlich adsorption isotherm is the base for Langmuir adsorption isotherm. Okay? In 1916, Langmuir proposed his theory of adsorption of gases on the surface of a solid. And then he considered some considerations, assumptions, which are they? Where does it now? First assumption is that the adsorbed gas behaves ideally in the vapor phase. The adsorbate should be ideal in the nature. Second one, only a monolayer is formed by the adsorbed gas. The adsorbed gas should be formed only a single layer, not a multiple layer. Okay, Langmuir assumptions does not allow to bilayer or multilayer. Okay, third, the surface of a solid is homogeneous so that each binding site having the same affinity for the gas molecules. Langmuir assumed that the surface of a solid should be homogeneous, plane. Crystal perfection or cracks does not allow in the Langmuir assumptions. Okay. Next, why the homogeneous? Because due to homogeneous surface, the surface molecules have the same affinity towards the gas molecules. The fourth assumption is that there is no lateral interaction between the adsorbed gas molecules. The adsorbate gas molecules which are adsorbed on the gas, solid surface, there is no interaction. Lateral interaction means two gas molecules can't react with each other. This is the fourth assumption of Langmuir. Fifth, the adsorbed gas molecules are localized. That is, they are not move around the surface. That means the adsorbed gas molecules have to be fixed on the adsorbed surface. Okay, they can't move around the surface. These are total five assumptions or considerations for Langmuir adsorption isotherm. On these five assumptions, he derived an expression which is used to calculate the amount of adsorbed gas molecules. To calculate the amount of gas molecules. Okay. Now, let us discuss about the expression. Let V is the equilibrium volume of gas adsorbed per unit mass of adsorbent. Vm will be the volume of the gas required to cover unit mass of the adsorbent with complete monolayer. And the P is the pressure. These are our considerations. Okay. If adsorption is assumed to be similar to a reversible reaction, such as adsorption is the opposite reaction of desorption, we can write it as X is the gaseous molecule plus surface, solid surface. Then if adsorption is occurs, then X gaseous molecules will adsorb on the surface. And if the reaction as the reaction is reversible, the desorption will be occur. Then X adsorbent will be desorbed from the surface. This is a reversible reaction. At the dynamic equilibrium is eventually established between the two opposing processes, that is adsorption and desorption. Okay, from statistical mechanics, we can write the rate of adsorption and desorption. Okay, so for the adsorption, which factors are affect on the adsorption? The rate of adsorption depends on the rate at which gas molecules collides with the solid surface, which is proportional to pressure P. Okay, the rate of adsorption is depend on pressure. Second factor is that the probability of striking a vacant sites. The vacant sites is available there, and the probability to strike the gaseous molecules on that vacant site is also the factor on which the adsorption depends. Third factor is that activation energy for adsorption, okay, which is equals to e raised to minus e upon rt, okay. That is the rate of adsorption is equals to k1p into 1 minus v upon vm into e raised to minus e upon rt. This is nothing but the rate of adsorption, okay, where k1 is the rate constant for adsorption and the rate of desorption is depend on the fraction of a surface which is covered, okay. If surface get covered with the gas molecules, then only the desorption possible. Therefore, the first factor is the fraction of a surface which is covered, which is denoted by V upon Vm, okay. Second term is that activation term, that is e raised to minus e prime upon rt, where e prime is the activation energy for desorption. That is, we can write the rate of desorption is equals to k2 v upon vm into e raised to minus e prime upon rt, where k2 is the rate constant for desorption, okay. Then at equilibrium condition, rate of adsorption is equals to rate of desorption. Now we will put the values of adsorption, rate of adsorption and rate of desorption. That is k1 into p into 1 minus v upon vm into e raised to minus e upon rt is equals to k2 v upon vm into e raised to minus e prime upon rt. Okay, then after solving this equation, after rearranging this equation, we get P is equals to K into E raised to delta H for adsorption upon RT into V upon Vm upon V minus V by Vm. Okay, then assuming that the heat of adsorption is independent of surface coverage, then we take a constant A, where 1 upon A is equals to K into E raised to delta H adsorption per RT, okay. This 1 upon A value put in the equation, P is equals to K into E raised to delta H adsorption per RT into V upon Vm upon 1 minus V by Vm, okay. Then we get the equation P is equals to 1 upon A into V upon Vm upon 1 minus V by Vm. After rearranging this equation, we get the value V upon Vm is equals to AP upon 1 plus AP. Consider that equation number 3, or we can also rearrange this equation as V is equals to AP upon 1 plus AP into Vm. Okay, and this is nothing but the Langmuir equation. Equation 3 and equation 4 are known as Langmuir equation. By using this equation, we can calculate the equilibrium volume of the gas adsorbed per unit mass. Okay, and one more thing is that in the some references, V upon Vm is equals to theta. The theta term is used, and also the constant A is replaced by K. Then our equation like B, theta is equals to Kp upon 1 plus Kp, where K, A is replaced by K and theta is equals to V upon Vm. The theta is equals to number of adsorbed sites occupied divided by number of adsorption sites available. Okay, theta is nothing but the fraction of the surface sites occupied by gas molecules. Okay, by using this equation, we can calculate the surface fraction of the surface sites occupied by the gas molecules. Okay, this is Langmuir equation, and it is applicable at only low pressure. Okay, there are some limitations also, which are: the first assumption holds at low pressure, means if we increase the pressure, the first assumption, that is gas molecule should be ideal in nature, is false. It breaks down, okay. The second assumption breaks down the way the pressure of the gas is increased. Then third assumption is not strictly true because the real surfaces are quite heterogeneous, so that affinity for gas molecules is different at different sites. And the crystal imperfections or cracks lead to the creation of different sites on the surface. Therefore, the assumptions becomes false. The fourth and fifth assumptions too are not strictly valid. At higher pressure, the assumptions are not valid, and therefore after the Langmuir adsorption isotherm, the BT theory is proposed by Brunner, Emmett, and Taylor, which is known as BET theory. We will discuss in the next video. Okay, I hope you like this video. If yes, then share with your friends and don't forget to subscribe the channel. Okay, thank you so much for watching this video.